And you know, in the next few days, the weather is going to go up, the temperature's up, then the temperature's down, then the temperature's up again. And you know what else has done that sometimes? Oh yeah, the markets. They've had a wild ride in 2020, so how will they finish out the year and what can we predict for 2021? Well, Alex Szarka joins us live now for more on this. Alex, thanks for being here.
Hi, how you doing? Thanks for having me.
Doing great. Well, as we mentioned there, the markets have had a wild ride this year, probably more up than down, but what are your thoughts? How do you think they're going to finish out this year?
Yeah, 2020 was an extremely volatile year. I mean, we just think about what we went through just this year alone. We went through an impeachment, a global economic shutdown, 40% drop in the market, a huge drop in the bond market, massive riots, forest fires, hurricanes, oh, and an extremely contentious election to top it off. So, yeah, 2020 has just basically been a complete dumpster fire of a year. But, you know, despite the unprecedented amount of drama, you know, after March 23rd, the stock market just took off on, you know, virtually nothing but bad news. But now that, you know, we see that the vaccines are here, now that we see another round of stimulus from the government, you know, our guess is the markets will probably continue to climb north of where they are now. The NASDAQ's up about, it's an amazing, about 43% year to date. S&P is up about 15%. The Dow 30 is up about 6% year to date. For conservative investors, overall, it's taken bonds longer to recover from the bottom. But we think that parts of the bond market will continue to do well since, you know, the Federal Reserve has no plans to stop propping it up with its bond buying.
And so looking forward then into 2021, do you expect this this upward trend to continue? And is it too late? Is it too late for people to get in on that?
Well, the next hurdle that we see that we need to get over is the Georgia runoff elections on January 5th. These are significant because these two elections will really determine the direction of our country, at least for the next 2 years. If the Democrats win both races, they'll have a supermajority in the House, Senate, and the White House, which basically means they're calling all the shots. And there's some concerns there on two ends. The markets don't like it when either party is calling all the shots. Wall Street likes checks and balances and some gridlock. The other concern is the fundamental changes to the government that the Democrats have been talking about doing all year long, like adding on states like Puerto Rico, D.C., stacking the Supreme Court, killing the filibuster. And these are some really radical changes that could cause the country to become even more divisive and we can continue to see more volatility. So overall, I mean, we're definitely a lot more optimistic than we were in February and March, but we don't think we're out of the woods yet for 2021.
And as we close out 2020, we have 2 days left here. Are there any end of the year financial housekeeping things that investors need to keep in mind or do before things close out?
Yeah, well, first would be a reminder for retirees that take their RMDs or their required minimum distributions from their IRAs at the end of the year. RMDs are the amount that the government forces you to take out of your IRA after you turn 72. It was 70 and a half last year. They just changed it to 72 for 2020. RMDs were suspended this year due to the government shutdown. As far as we know, RMDs will be reinstated for 2021. So for viewers that, you know, haven't taken any distributions for 2020, you know, and they're planning on making a big purchase, it might make sense just to wait a few, just a few days till 2021 to fulfill next year's R&D. Also, the end of the year is also a great time to, you know, reevaluate your portfolio, see how much risk that you're taking, or tax optimize your non-retirement accounts for any end of the year capital gains distributions that mutual funds may kick off. So yeah, if viewers aren't sure or if they're looking for a second opinion, obviously just give us a call and we're happy to help.
All right. Always good advice. Alex Szarka, thanks so much for being here. And if you have financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head over to our website, fox8.com, and click Seen on TV.